So now we have to recalculate the everything with op amp. So how do we do this with op amp RC? It's quite simple, huh? You have to just this is R1, I'll call it RP, and you have CI. Okay. And if you remember, this was nothing but your feedback resistor. So from V out to your output, or this is V control, which is output of your compensator, the transfer function remains same. So if I want to write the transfer function of this, HCOM, so beta will not come here. In the GM we have a beta, but here beta will not come because of this virtual ground. Okay. So it should be RP plus 1 over SCI minus, okay, which is nothing but RP over R1 plus 1 over so this is your KP and this is your KI. So what is the difference if you compare with GM? The only difference is R1 is replaced with 1 over GM. Rest of the things remain same. And so which means we were considering GM 1 milli, here R1 is already there, we were considering 100k also. Okay. So if R1 is 100k and beta factor is gone, so what would happen to the value of RP? So KU 0. So KU 0 was?
KU 0 was.
No, the loop gain is half. Huh?
Initially half, but
now it's double. So your proportional gain will be half. So the resistance will be half. So R1 is 100k. RP requirement will be half of RP calculated in and that is nothing but 4k by 2, correct, which is how much? No, that, sorry, first let us look at GMRP should be or KP should be, okay, because the KP there was GM into R, here KP is RP by R1, so it is depending on R1, so your RP value will change accordingly. So what was the GMRP? 4 in the previous one. 4, huh? So equal to 2, which means, and R1 is known 100k and omega z, sorry, RP over R1 is 2, this implies RP equal to how much? 200k? Any confusion? What is Ci? You know the location of 0? What was the location of 0? Omega naught by 2, So, and what is the 0?
1 by RPC.
Omega z is 1 over?
RPCi.
So, from here you can calculate. RP you have already calculated. So, what is Ci? 1 over omega z into RP, correct? This was 0.09 omega naught by 2. So, this becomes 10 power minus 11 over 0.18. How much is this? Picofarad. Okay. So, let us convert it to op amp RC. I may have, let me see. Yeah. I will remove this. Okay. 3.3 microhenry. Pretty close to 100k, 96k, and let us look at the phase response. So, phase margin is better here compared to the previous one. Okay. So, this is how you do your type 2 using op amp RC, but the problem with this type 2 is one important thing to notice here, your cap value which was getting coming like pretty close to 1 nanofarad, 800 picofarad, now reduced to 55 picofarad. Because now you have a freedom to use larger R without disturbing your offset, because offset is mainly determined by your op amp gain and GM of the op amp. So, here there GM op amp you can use as high as possible, okay. You can, I mean, depending on the offset, you can choose higher GM, and choosing the higher GM will not affect your capacitor value because cap is only depending on your R. So, that is the advantage here. Requires a smaller capacitor. Okay. okay, your output ripple is increased. Why it is increased? Because, so if I call it delta V naught ripple, what will be this? Delta L into RESR. So, delta V out total will become delta IL into RESR plus delta. So, what do we need to do? We need to have this 0 introduced somewhere else, but not in the output cap. Therefore, we need to add additional 0, or I will call it second 0. In the compensator, okay.